We are going to fix our inner cities and rebuild our highways, bridges, tunnels, airports, schools, hospitals. We're going to rebuild our infrastructure.
That was President-elect Donald Trump promising to invest in America's infrastructure. So what is his plan exactly, and how will he pay for it? CNN chief business correspondent Christine Romans joins us to break it all down. Christine, great to see you.
Good morning.
I have a political question for you before we start. Why do Republicans love this $1 trillion infrastructure plan when they hated President Obama's infrastructure stimulus plan?
I'm not sure they all love this infrastructure plan. They want to make sure, I think, that it's paid for, it's really paid for. So there is some controversy on how this is going to look. Let's talk about what it is they want to do here first. Donald Trump, and we don't have a blueprint per se, pun intended, but we do know that Donald Trump wants to spend about $1 trillion over 10 years. And here's how that stacks up. Hillary Clinton's plan on the campaign trail was $275 billion over 5 years. And this is the American Society of Civil Engineers says we got a lot of stuff to fix. They say we need to spend almost $4 trillion by 2020. There's a lot to do.
But a big distinguishing characteristic is that Clinton was going to do the normal funding mechanism, which a lot of the GOP doesn't like, which is raising taxes or floating debt to make it happen. Mm-hmm. Trump has a different idea of how to do it that essentially will privatize a lot of our nation's infrastructure, and that's causing some controversy, too. It's complicated. How did you explain it?
It's complicated, and it's sort of creative. So let's look at what needs to be done first. You know, where will all of this money be invested before we get to it? This is the traditional stuff, right?
Right.
You know, think LaGuardia Airport. Airports, air traffic control systems, creaky, out of date.
Right.
Long-term clean water projects, energy pipelines, and coal facilities.
Right.
Remember those coal jobs? Security infrastructure. You just heard him in that video last night talking about protecting against cyber attacks of America's infrastructure. That could be technology spending that is infrastructure spending, not necessarily
very expensive.
A shovel in the ground.
America's got old hardware. Literally changing
the computer.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Grid. This is needed. It's hard to argue against it, but it's just who pays for it and how does it get done. And remember, as President Obama famously said when he failed, basically, at the infrastructure building, well, the shovel-ready projects weren't as shovel-ready as I thought. So what's different now?
And that's interesting because I was hearing from CEOs last week that they think there's still not as many shovel-ready projects as you would
like. What does that mean, shovel-ready? They don't have the jobs?
It means that they're not ready to go with appropriate permits, with the appropriate EPA approvals, with the appropriate
Maybe those are some of the regulations.
Exactly. So look, this is the public-private partnership you're talking about, how to pay for it. $137 billion in federal tax breaks to private investors. So tell investors, we're gonna give you some tax breaks so that you can get in on this. Instead of just making it state and federal government, local governments, we're going to have private investors. And also new tax revenue. All these new workers, a growing economy is going to be new tax revenue. The criticism is this only addresses kind of a narrow slice of infrastructure spending here.
But also, you would have tax dollars put out to help float this project, but then you'd have it privately owned at the end of it, so all the revenue from the tolls wind up going to this investor group, not back to taxpayers.
Exactly. Now, there are other ways to get revenue, too. Think of, like, water services and, you know, things that have a steady stream of revenue that come in. So there's some things that
Do we want private companies owning our bridges?
Exactly.
Like,
there's also other ideas. Direct government investment. Cutting regulations and red tape. That would free up some money. Think of this. This is one of his, Stephen Moore, one of his advisors, has said, if you had a tax holiday for the trillions of dollars that big companies have overseas, that money would come back here. The taxes that would be paid, even though it would be less taxes than the 35% corporate rate, could be used to fund this. Mm. And there's also the idea of an infrastructure bank, right? So you have the Congress puts in a bunch of money into a bank, and that bank then also takes in private investors and works together, giving returns and loans that way to do deals. Let's talk about what the pushback is. To go back to your first question, here's what Bernie Sanders has said. Trump's plan to repair infrastructure is a scam that gives massive tax breaks to large companies and billionaires. That's what he says. If you look at...
That bridge needs help.
The bridge needs help.
Yeah, that is a shovel-ready project.
That is shovel-ready.
Yeah. Listen to Paul Ryan.
Donald Trump pass a $550 billion or more infrastructure program. Would that be something that you would help him achieve?
That's not in the Better Way agenda.
That's not in the Better Way agenda.
Just so you know, we just passed the biggest highway bill in the mid-1990s.
Does not sound like a ringing endorsement of Donald Trump's plan to spend a whole bunch of money, and that's when that was a $550 billion infrastructure bank, not
a
trillion.
Was it the slapping of his knee that made you think he didn't agree with it?
I think, look, Congress is going, this is all going to have to go through Congress, so Donald Trump is going to have a delicate dance here. I'll tell you one other thing that CEOs were saying to me. They like the idea of spending infrastructure. It's one of the reasons why the stock market is so high right now. But they're worried there aren't enough workers for some of these.
Wow.
4.9% unemployment, $1 trillion over 10 years. You're talking about hundreds of thousands of people have to be put to work, and they're worried they can't find the people.
Mm. Christine, thanks so much for helping us understand all of this.
And as they define it more, we'll come back to it and tell you what makes sense and what doesn't. So there was a big historic event in the NFL.